It's not.
Good morning.
We're here today on many persons to thank officers for the upcoming year or two. We have Brother James Sears, who's chaired our nominating committee. We're going to turn this over to this time to Brother Sears.
Thank you. I didn't receive anything at all, but
I make a motion by acclamation to accept the study presented.
Any discussion by acclamation? Is there a second?
Second.
But then move to second by acclamation, that we submit, that we accept the listing of names of the officers. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Second Vice President, Mr. Moses Matthew. Third Vice President, Mr. Mrs. Smith. Fourth Secretary, Mr. Selby. Secretary, Mr. Ross.
She was there to make sure we got it.
Morning.
I do want to thank all of you, the nominating committee, for this opportunity. We need each other. We need each other. And how many sometimes? Since I got a few minutes. But I would like to take a few minutes to reflect. As a young man, and I would come to those meetings and I would sit there and just respect the many people that were in those meetings. And you know, they say that after we pass, after one generation, our names aren't mentioned anymore. But I just want to take the time out to call out a few names that influenced me from this organization. But ones that really stood out to me were gentlemen named Ike Battle of Gates County. Of course, ED, but Mr. Nams from here in Warrington, Mr. Bigham from Beaufort County, Ed Bob Jones from Lenore County. Ernest Hugh Ham, and our own Mr. James Civic, at that time he had hair and it was black. But this organization has been one of the strongest organizations, black organizations in the state. I want us to go back to that. There was a time that anytime someone was going to run for a state position, they came and met with this organization.
That's right.
Now, the way that we want to build that back up is we've got to have, you see, all those are the 28 counties that are in the Eastern North Carolina City. We You got to come up with a strategy to get those counties back involved. Now, if we can get those involved, and it doesn't take 20 people from each one of those counties to come to this meeting. It only takes one. And one comes and gets the information, because the information that comes to this group is true, it's pure, and it's helpful. And if we can get one person from each of these counties to attend these meetings and to go back home and to tell the message, we will again be that organization that elected officials will be to leadership. We've got a great executive committee, Brother Bond, Mr. Matthews, Vanessa Smith, I do not know. And we've got a great secretary with our bed. Ms. Shaw, I do not know. Maybe Seal, I don't know. Reverend Gray, I don't know. But we will work. I need you all to help guide me. And I told Mr. Sears, as long as he, Mr. Matthews, and Mr. Bond, and the executive committee stays beside me, with me, that we will be successful. So I do, again, I'm thanking you all for this choice. And I pray that we will see some more chairs being moved, some more counties coming in. And if they take any new car going to some of these counties, finding out people movers and shakers are in the community. That's what it takes, that's what I'm going to do. But again, thank you so much.
Any questions or concerns? This is the time of the speech. And we look forward to serving, sharing with us your insights. He had the view that a handful of us could do all of it. And I remember so many times that we went to meetings with EV, and particularly at the state level, we would go to meetings. And he simply walked in to wherever it was, in Raleigh, wherever. He simply walked in and turned and said to us, come on. And there were people who had obviously paid to get in, and he just walked in. He made his plan. And people from across the state who were elected officers had tremendous respect for him. He served in various positions. And I don't know how many of you all remember, there were, he served for a school, I think it was two terms, he served on the State Board of Education. And we went to those meetings, and still we were instructors and all those kinds of things. And we simply walked in, and meetings had just kept us. The force of personality is just about that, but it's kind of that sad. And it was a tremendous. Some of the names of the persons that Mr. Stokes just mentioned a few minutes ago, George Bailey from Oakland, I had a great family. Bob Jones from the North Carolina.
Jeremy has a announcement that, first of all, good morning and welcome to the Providence Black Acre Connectivity Campus. I'm always excited to host the Civic Group, and as I told the leadership before, the leadership right now, this is your home. You want to be here, you want to meet here in person, virtually. This campus purchased last June to be a connectivity space for all of Eastern North Carolina. We are a broadband service provider, but also a digital skills and community connectivity space. We want to provide 21st century jobs and opportunities for folks, particularly those of us who need it the most. So I'm excited to host the committee this morning, any morning, or any event that you want to have here. My announcement is on May the 6th, we're hosting a community engagement right here on the campus from 9 to 2. 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Folks come out, have some breakfast for you, and then we share vision with folks in the community. Again, we're trying to serve county from Nash County to Dare County, from Greene County up to the Virginia border. And so May the 6th, Saturday, May the 6th from 9 to 2. We'll start out with some visioning, and then we invite people to help us clean out the buildings. If there's furniture in any of these buildings that you need for your church, for your student, child, or you know, community program that you have, anything we have here that you can use, we want you to take it with you. And then we're going to have a fish fry, have a DJ, and some music, and it'll be a really awesome opportunity. We'll have some games on the yard that day, but May the 6th, from 9 to 2. And then we're actually co-sponsoring the event this year with our cigar club, which is called the Good Time Game. And so after the fish fry, we'll have a little smoke out in the yard as well for any of you that like cigars, but we're going to be doing that as well. So it's going to be a fun time. I appreciate the Civic Group for always partnering with us and look forward to continuing partnering with you.
Good morning. It's such a pleasure to be with you all. Some of you I haven't seen in a long time, and I was so happy to see you this morning. God is good. I bring you in from North Hampton County. My husband Ronald could not be with me today. He's very active too in politics. They were having their convention this morning, Democratic Party convention, at the county seat in Jackson. So he sends his regards to the new president. I'm so excited. I'm sitting there thinking, wow, I was wondering who was going to take the ball and roll with it. And I see now that it's going to be all of us working together and a new president. So I'm excited. Mr. Sears, thank you and Betty so much for keeping us posted. We've been through some hard times. Ron lost his mom, and we've had so many deaths in our area from different reasons and under certain circumstances. But God has been good. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Vanessa Smith. I'm an outdoor person, love folk, and love to talk. Okay? I have five beautiful kids that God has installed in them the same gift my parents installed in me, and that is to work hard and to achieve. My daughter LaRonda, who lives in Hampton, was one of the number one black engineer, female engineer, for the Black Engineer Association of America. She was awarded at the Gaylord Resort back in March. My daughter Veronica is the director of operations, getting ready to go into a regional position for KIPP. KIPP is a charter school that came to Eastern North Carolina from out of New York and out of the California area. Shannon, my baby girl, is an assistant principal at KIPP Halifax. And they are growing and not trying to take away from other schools, but to make sure that nothing, no one falls through the crack. My son, Ronald Jr., is in Philadelphia celebrating two new kids. And he is an entrepreneur and a book designer, as well as a teacher at home right now helping his wife out. My other son, who is actually my adopted son, my sister was in a bad accident when she was in the Army. And at age 13, my husband and I took him back in. I had raised him when she first went into the military from age 0 until 3. Then she was able to come back to the States, and she took him until she was 13, had a bad accident, stayed in a coma until her death. And we raised her son. And Chico is doing well. He is a transport driver for a company out of New Jersey, and is doing well. So God has been good to me. I have come through what they said was thyroid cancer, and there's no cancer. I've come through what they said was inflammation of the lungs, and there's no inflammation. I've come through ups and downs, but I'm here now, and I'm so excited to get this moving. And anything I can do for any of you at any time, just pick up the phone and call me. If I can't come, I'll tell you, but I'll send somebody else. I'll do all I can. Thank you.
I do have an update on the economic side, economic opportunities coming with the Eastern Alpha. Y'all know the driver was used in Hampton Hills. Now we're talking Hampton Fire. Carol and I were able to go to the conference this past Monday and Tuesday. Had all these managers and owners of various textile, this is the Southern Textile Association. The movement now is to be able to incorporate hemp fiber with cotton. And it's going to come in different degrees, maybe 10% hemp, 90% cotton. Some of the folks we met dealing with hemp, and we're talking about taking that plant and making the material just as soft as silk, or making towels, or anything we're looking at, you have to be made out of hemp. The point I want to make is that we planted hemp for fiber for the first time, and we'll be coming in on No Pond Road. This is discovered next week, and we have that's our activity. Our first. What we're trying to do is get the black man on this to make sure they don't try to land up multiple year leases. And we're trying to make sure that the dollars will be prepared for what they're making out of peanuts, corn, whatever. And we also want to make sure that this mistake stage in the district. This is ground zero. And it's really an opportunity for black families, black landowners. And I'm using black landowners and black farmers. On the land and then you can create a farm for our most of a lot of farms, leasing out land for years. Work that lease back into the family structure and give your grandkids, great grandkids, fall in love with farming. And what we lack is that seed money being reliable. And I want to do that every day that you can take someone from a different discipline. Where we're working right now to be able to sustain them and be able to move their way of life long enough for the family and the entity to become money making the budget. But this will take all of us to pool those concepts together. The train has already started and it's making the muzzle stop, so we just need to get on. Anything we can do, Alabama Farm Co-op, that's who I represented this past week up there. We've got membership from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania to Dallas, Texas. In between, the folks who in these areas are on land and off their mind and part of what we've been trying to do for the last 3 or 4 years. Just give us a call and we'll share whatever information we have ready.
If you do, if you want to get your license, go ahead.
You're going to have to get your license to help you get your federal license. I just told you that if the planning campus, we let folks use our license, folks, you got to remember your problem. At least 7 or 8 of us have a federal license.
Yes, I would like to say, bring your greetings from Edgecombe County. And I've been coming to this meeting off and on since probably early 90s. I think the first meeting I attended was down around Plymouth. What was the name of the little place it was at? It was a church, I think.
Roper.
That's right, Roper. And I was very excited then, and I'm excited now. When I came today, I didn't know who the officers were up for election, but I was glad to see my good friend, Brother Stokes, is now the president. Learned something about where I was coming to. I didn't know where I was coming to. I was so used to going to the technology center, and I was like, where is this at? So I put it in my own star, and then I didn't think I was going to never find a place. But I was glad to see my brother back here, Jeremy. I think I met him through the NAACP years ago when he was in school. So I know I don't look like it, but 60 years old Christmas Day, been out here a long time, and I'm just overjoyed with seeing those guys like Jeremy and Wesley and other young folk that I met across the state, NAACP, Democratic Party, doing some great things, and I'm gonna support them until the day I die. And I look forward to the Eastern North Carolina Civic Group meetings because me and Brother Sears go way back, Reverend Fred Yates. I miss my good friend, Mr. Pugh. I had the opportunity to video his funeral. I like document stuff. I do this stuff out of pocket, been doing it for years. The Lord blessed me with a good job, aerospace job in Rocky Mountain, North Carolina. I've been there 36 years. When I first started, it was Bendix, and I could have retired at 55. It was aging points. They sold us out about 3 times, so now I got to work forever, but ain't no problem with that. It ain't no hard work, and I love working. Been working ever since I was 5 years old. Worked when I didn't have to. Worked 2 jobs, 3 jobs, didn't have to. Never wanted for anything, but to make sure people around me is happy. If I ain't happy, if they ain't happy, I ain't happy. You know, we got to live together, so I look forward to this meeting. And a lot of time I work on Saturdays volunteer, but the pandemic came. I was doing it online, make sure I got off work on time on Saturday morning so I could tune in. A lot of time I was at the car wash. Me to the car wash the whole time, listening to the meeting, joining in. So I'm glad we're back doing it live so I can video it. I'm live streaming now. taking pictures. You know, this is what I do. I like to document history so people can see what we're doing, and also so I can hold folk accountable. That's really why I come and start videoing back in the day, hold people accountable. And you see, I didn't say that, and I can pay it back for them. So I love it. But I just want to say anything I can do. I think I did serve as a publicity chair before the pandemic. So anything I can do, any information, make sure you get it to me so I can share it with folk and get the word out. And again, I'm just happy. I had a big event in Edgecombe County this morning. The Phoenix Historical Society is dealing with redistricting. And I had to come right through Tallboro. I live in Pine Top. I had to come through Tallboro to come here. But I had to be here because this right here is, like I said, my heart. I'm a diehard Democrat. I'm a diehard life member, fully paid member of the NAACP. And like I said, I'm about documenting history. And I know a lot of people don't come to these meetings from Edgecombe County. Reverend Roy Gray and some others might come, you know, come time to time. He's basically here. But I'm going to come and get the word out so I can pass it on, not only to Edgecombe County, because like I said, I'm live streaming it, so people looking at it all over. So anything I can do, I just want to say, I think I saw Brother Stokes in Tallboro not long ago, him and the kids. And I said, I know that guy there. He was looking at me, and I was looking at him. So it's just glad, and you know, it's good to know people across the state. You don't never know who you may need. I was listening at you talking about the thing going on in New Bern. Well, my wife is from New Bern, been married since 97. And everything. So, but I'm gonna shut it off because I love to talk too about things that we're doing in the community. Because if we come together as Black people, we can do a whole lot of things, and we don't have to. We need to do it by the book. I'm a policy and procedure man. We can't do stuff that they used to do because you're going to jail, and I ain't got no money to get you out. So, do what's right, and if they don't re-elect you, I'm talking about our elected officials. If you don't do what's right, then as long as you did what was right, I mean, do what's right, and if people don't vote you back in, you can go home and sleep at night. That's how I look at it. You can only do so much. You can't, you know, you have no control of how people receive what you do, but as long as you're doing what's right, the Lord gonna stay, you know, be with you. So I just appreciate it. Thank y'all for the time.
Thank you all. He always talked about this organization. He always brought some good information back to the NAACP and to the Democratic Party. So I got a big shoes to fill, but I will try my little best to fill those shoes that minister to this ball. Anyway, you can get into James Pickens. All you got to do is say, hey, girl!
And Mr. President, I can't leave out Ms. Betty Silvery for her job she has done over the years.
Yes.
She's just like a sister. I mean, I appreciate you. I look forward to getting that email from you.
People of the district spoke right back in. That's kind of the crew came back down, I was putting the cable on the wire. So that thing, and so the sales rep from electric called me, and that required me to put the cable for that. She was negotiating with me about I want 60 minute service and 100 minute service. I want the telephone service and all that. I mean, it's just because that I've been on satellite for the last 8 to 10 years, I guess. And all of you know that it's getting ready. So, it is probably communicated. It's just kind of close to that. Now, and one other thing. I need to say to you all, and I hear all of you make comments and answers, that the Lord is in charge of all this. And I would say to you that the Democratic conventions that would be held across the area, because in my cabinet, but we need to work as hard as we can to get more Democratic office holders in place. You know, just this past week in the North Carolina legislature, the young lady's court switched from Democrat to Republican, and that made supermajorities in the Senate and the House. And that's a real struggle. Just to give you an idea of how dark that is, and he said good night again, just how dark that is. You all know what the U.S. Constitution's order in case somebody passes president or the vice president. And in this case right now, Lord forbid if something were to happen to Joe Biden or to Kamala Harris, but do you know who's next in line? Do you know who's next in line? McCarthy. Wait. The Speaker of the House would be the person who would be in line if something happened to them. Can you imagine what events we would have? Think about that. And so I would have encouraged us all to do all we can toward homosexuality. The Democrat had been in here this morning, and I was especially about what Jeremy said about the 6th of May. I wish we would pass that word on and then have to include that in the next, because that would be before our next meeting.
To add, if folks send me a graphic or something before the meeting, I can put them up like we're doing with this now. I had an announcement about more on Monday, I mean the 6th as well, so you can get the information. Mm-hmm. But I appreciate y'all's support.
Let me, not
to
cut off, but since you said one more thing, one thing that I saw this week, in searching for my grandson, who is a senior this year, and I thought to myself, this is important and we should know it. As a I'm a retired school teacher, 37 years, but as a citizen, still working in education and advocating for our students, what we really need to do, I was talking with the scholarship department at North Carolina Central, and And what I discovered in that conversation was that we have a lot of sororities and fraternities and alumni alums that have supported our colleges here in North Carolina and throughout. But what is happening to Eastern North Carolina, and you can ask yourself, look at your schools now as seniors are getting ready to graduate. How many of those colleges are presenting those students with scholarships?
Mm.
Because we're still a poor area, and we're still in need of educational funds for our children. And in talking with them, for my grandson, I discovered that a lot of monies that was on the table for scholarships did not come to Eastern North Carolina. Why? Perhaps we didn't ask, or perhaps our schools were not high performing on the ranks they thought they should be. But nevertheless, our parents, who I will mention, are getting letters saying their students are honor students, their students are in this crossover, they're in this category. So we should see some funds. We should see more scholarship funding coming to Eastern North Carolina for our schools. And that's something, if you have graduated from a college or university, don't mind getting on the phone and ask, do you have any students that you are aware of that are coming from my community? And tell me what your county is and your community is. Because I was just shocked when I was asking for my grandson in Northampton County. And yes, we have suffered greatly with COVID and before COVID, with a lot of teachers not coming because of the economic development not being there for jobs and things, and our children have suffered greatly. But still, it wasn't just Northampton County that was at risk. It was other counties too that just we're not getting funding like we should, and the money is on the table. Our students maybe need to apply themselves more. Our counselors need to maybe apply themselves more. Parents need to get on the phone, because I'm a grandmother on the phone for a grandson, and say, is there any funds left? You know, my husband graduated from Central. He's applied to Central. My grandson's applied, he's been accepted. But you have, and he's got a 3.0, he's got 2 years in the early college, and he's coming in. If you can support him. Now, he's got a student in Illinois who has given him a full 4-year ride, put him on the football team. He went out there last week, met with his coaches and his counselor. They told him how many credits they would accept and everything. Told him how they would put him on the plane to get him home when he needed to come home. Now, we got to do better. We got to do better. This is us. We're North Carolina. That's all I need to say. But be alert to that. Be aware of that. And work hard to get our schools to support our children. We know Elizabeth City does a great job because those schools have been able to downplay their tuition costs. But there are other schools whose children still want to go to, and they don't have that advantage. So let's get on the ball, get on the phone, and talk to these people, get our community to, if we're going to be a part of sending them funds and capitalists and raising money for this and sending them donations, we want to see some of our donations come back.
I'd like to add on to what Jesse just said real quickly, something I learned in the past month. And it's the dollars are dedicated to and earmarked for Chairman County. That the Wilson School of Technology has a $50,000 a year centennial grant for that school of design. I'm not sure, and then living in our home, we need to come up with a special task team and the guidance council. All the families are complaining that they just don't get the time. I know I'm not.
I just got one last announcement. Since I've been here, I'm sorry. Yeah, I was just going to say, since I've been here, I got a call from Congressman Don Davis' office making me aware of he's going to have a meeting at the headquarters in Greenville on Tuesday. And I'm quite sure you'll get the information, but I'll send it to you when I get it. I'll tell him to text it to him, but he haven't texted it yet. But it'll be in Greenville Tuesday at 10 o'clock in the morning. That's right.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.